Hello everyone, I am going to explain question number 6th from exercise 3.1 from class 11th. Here the question 6th is, if in two circles arc of same length subtend 60 degree and 75 degree at the center, then find the ratio of their radii. So here we have to find out the ratio of the radius. So students, we know that length of arc formula is pi r theta upon 180. So length of arc of first circle is here pi r theta. What theta is available for the first circle? That is 60 degree. And for the second circle, the length of arc is 75 degree. So here we have to find out the ratio between the radius of first circle and radius of the second circle. For that, what we are going to do, what we had done is, we had calculated the length of arc of first circle and length of arc of the second circle, because here it is given that same length of arc subtends. Means in two circles, whatever be the angle 60 degree and 75 degree, they subtend the same length of arc. So length of arc are same. So that's why we need the formula for length of arc. The length of arc formula is pi r theta upon 180. That's why we calculated the length of arc of first circle. In that we substituted theta as 60 degree, and in second time we substituted instead of theta 75 degree. And since it is available that both the length of arc are same, that's why we kept them equal. Now from here, see students, pi and pi will cancel. This 180 and 180 will cancel, and we want r1 upon r2. So this r2 I shifted here, this 60 I shifted there, so it's going to be 75 upon 60. Now since both have degrees, so degree and degree will also cancel. Now just cut it by, cancel them by 50. So you will obtain 5 upon 4. So ratio of R1 and R2 is 5 ratio 4. So how we had done this? By this information that length of arc are same. So we calculated the length of arc of first circle and length of arc of second circle by the 10th class formula pi r theta upon 180. Now since both the arcs length are same, that's why we kept them equal, and from there we got the ratio R1 and R2. Now we move to the question number 7, and in question number 7 the question is, find the angle in radian through which a pendulum swings if the length is 75 cm and tip describes an arc of length 10 cm, 15 cm and 21 cm. So I think figure is already available in your book. So students, here the length 25 cm, so since the pendulum's length is 25 cm, so it will behave as radius, and these arcs are behave as L. You know length of arc we should represent by L, so pendulum's length is going to be the radius, and the theta formula is L upon R. So in that they substitute the value, and since this formula is applicable for the radian measure, so whatever answer will come, that is also going to be radian. So cancel it, you will get 2 upon 15. In the same way, here we have 15 cm. So length of arc is 50 and radius, that is pendulum's length, that is 75. Cancel it, you will get 1 upon 5 radian. In next, again it's 21 cm. So substitute it, you will get 7 upon 25 radian. So to solve this question, we had used the concept that the pendulum's length is going to be the radius of the complete circle if it rotate a complete round. So length, it's 75 is the radius, and these length of arc are going to be L, and we are going to use the formula theta is equal to L upon R. So I hope question number 6th and 7th is clear to you. So if you have any doubt, you can tell, you can write in the comment box so that we can clear out. And I request that you just share it to your friends so that they can also watch and understand them. Thank you.